Hi there, I'm Seth Juarez, and I'm chatting with Microsoft researchers Katja Hofmann and Evelyne Viegas about Project Malmo, an AI testing environment based upon Minecraft. Welcome.
Hi, Seth.
How's everybody doing today?
Fantastic.
So, I heard about this topic recently, and it absolutely was really impressive. And here's why. Like I was talking before, I talked to Joshua Bengio about deep learning, and one of the things he said is that one of the state-of-the-art things that he wants to do is he wants to use deep learning for exploratory AI. So why don't you talk about Project Malmo and why this is a perfect piece of software for that? Why don't we start with you?
Absolutely. We really see Minecraft as one of those stepping stones that are going to allow us to push the state of the art in AI and eventually work towards more complex real-world applications. Two of the things that I'm really excited about that we can do in Malmo, which is based on Minecraft, is that first we can invest in this kind of lifelong learning. So coming up with approaches that bootstrap from smaller, kind of simpler tasks that learn common sense knowledge and then build that up to eventually solve harder and harder tasks. And the other part that I'm really excited about is this concept of collaborative AI. So what happens when you put more than one agent into an environment? For example, how can AI agents learn to collaborate? And what happens when you put a human in there? Can they learn to figure out what the human is trying to achieve and how they can help them achieve their goal?
Well, Project Malmo, tell us about it from your perspective.
Sure. So this is a very exciting project. And I actually want to bring right now the collaborative aspect that Katja was talking about. So in fact, when we started the project, when Katja started with the researchers like working on this project, we started interacting with the external community upfront, just to understand first what was the need, what were the requirements, and we did a few what we called some technology days, just to figure out to listen to the community. And pretty soon we figured out that actually it would be fantastic if we could work more closely with the community, which ended up bringing Malmo, this platform, to the open source. And since then, actually, we've had thousands of people who've been using it.
I mean, that's amazing. So you started up front by thinking, we're just going to put this out. What have people been doing? As you mentioned, thousands. What have people been doing with this, the technology?
Absolutely. So we were planning this as a tool for the research community from the start and really thinking about how such a platform could advance the state of the art in AI. One thing we hadn't really anticipated was the level of enthusiasm we get from outside the research community. We get high school students who learn to program on the Malmo platform, and it's really exciting for them because you can actually see what an algorithm does when you use it to steer an agent. We get a lot of interest from university professors who use it in their courses to teach students about concepts in AI, in programming, and reinforcement learning. So there's a huge diversity of users. A lot of times we only see the visitor numbers on GitHub. We see that there's a lot of people, but there's a lot bubbling under the surface that we're not even aware of. So if you have some cool uses for Malmo that you would like to tell us about, definitely get in touch. We're really eager to hear about that.
What's the most surprising thing you've seen people use Project Malmo for?
Gosh, I'll tell you first, who is the most surprising person I've seen?
Oh, let's do that, yeah.
So there was a sixth grader. Yes, who actually came to my office and was completely inspired. He was doing a visit as part of some students gathering at Microsoft. And he had heard about Malmo. Actually, he had really heard about Minecraft.
Right?
He
was
playing Minecraft.
Who hasn't, yes.
And so, but then he heard about Malmo and he was like, wow. So he started interacting actually with the researchers and say, you know, wow, now I can actually have some AI agents. I can play with that. I can learn about it. And so that was to me like probably the most surprising person like trying to use Malmo, also showing that the bar of entry can be as low or as high as we want it to be.
And that's amazing. Were they actually coding these things to go around and like mine stuff and build stuff? Or what was this sixth grader actually doing? Just interest, or what were they doing?
I think they were trying to do a little bit of both, right? The first thing they were really trying to learn about, like, what's this whole agent? How can I start coding? But actually, the person started coding, actually. So yes, it was really an environment like to experiment, to have fun with the characters he was very familiar with.
So let's talk about a test bed like Project Malmo. Why is it an important thing?
Well, in real-world applications, which, you know, in the long run, we really want to enable new real-world applications. We're not doing this for the sake of learning to play Minecraft.
Sure.
I mean, if that's what we need, we have people who are pretty good at this.
Sure.
But what we really want to is to isolate certain aspects of this whole huge problem of AI and start to make progress in those specific dimensions. And in a simulated environment like this, we can specifically construct the tasks that allow us to really push on those dimensions. So for example, if someone wants to do research on multimodal approaches that integrate language and visual aspects of an environment, this is something you can set up very easily in Malmo, and it allows you to really focus on the learning approach itself instead of having to do all this data collection, setting up a task in the real world, which can be much slower. And eventually we see this research to feed into the real world applications, but first we can push, really understand what's going on.
Why do you think it's such an important test bed?
Well, I think it's really important because I'm going to go back to the community.
Mm-hmm.
So actually I want to talk about a collaborative AI challenge that we've done recently.
Oh, interesting.
And this is one way, as Katja was mentioning earlier, really the goal of the platform, not just doing the platform for the sake of doing it, is really to help advance the state of the art, to get people engaged, also to use it for people maybe to just learn, like PhD students, but also some enthusiasts actually are interested in learning a bit about all these approaches. So the team put together a challenge, an AI challenge. So I think Katja will be describing it a bit later on in more detail. But I want to emphasize that the interesting part about that challenge is that it's really collaborative, and it's all really about collaborative AI. And I think that's something which we're trying to do, which is different from what is out there. And Project Malmo actually is ideal for that, which is bringing people together to try to do some specific task, like about creating something, or in the context of the challenge that we had, it was actually a task about like trying to catch a pig together.
That's awesome. But I feel like we've talked about this a lot. Can you show us a little demo on how this works? What do you got?
Absolutely. I think you can actually see this on the screen
totally
there.
Totally can.
What I have here is the task that we set out as the collaborative AI challenge.
Okay.
We are going to be a human agent interacting with another agent, and the task of the students was to actually create an agent that would take the role that we're playing here.
Okay.
So you can see here, we're getting ready to catch the pig. There are two agents in the small enclosure here. We are controlling the red agent here, and there's another one here in the corner.
Uh-huh.
To catch the pig, we actually have to corner it, so we have to collaborate. But that will only work if the other agent is actually able to collaborate with us.
Sure.
So let's see if they're a good collaborator.
So you're the red one and the blue one is the actual AI one.
Exactly.
Okay.
So you can see how I'm controlling this one over here. And you can already see that the other agent is moving towards the pig. So that's a pretty good indication that they're actually trying to collaborate with us. And this inference, this kind of understanding what the other agent's intentions are and how our plan, our behavior can fit in to coordinate with them, that is really the core of this challenge. If the other agent were to move around randomly or were trying to trick us, then that would have a different, we should draw a different conclusion. We shouldn't try to collaborate with them.
So this is interesting. Now, is this, because I'm looking at this and I can think of, because I'm kind of a programmer too, is this like, are people writing deterministic algorithms for them? Are they doing probabilistic? Are they going full AI machine learning? Because what are they doing for this?
Mm-hmm. Fantastic question. So we actually had 83 teams from around the world participating in this first version of the challenge. And what we saw in the winning teams was that there was a huge variety in terms of the approaches that people tried.
Okay.
Some people really went down the deep reinforcement learning route and had some great insights into how to learn efficiently in this kind of more complex modeling environment. Others went the classic AI route. Some spent a lot of time really manually modeling this environment. Some went via belief modeling and probabilistic inference. And at the moment, what we saw was that a lot of those approaches were kind of on par with each other. So what I'm looking forward to is seeing how those different communities, people with those different backgrounds can learn from each other, maybe integrate different ideas and use that to come up with more new innovative approaches to solving those kinds of collaborative tasks.
What surprised you about this challenge? Because I'm sure you put this out there and you're like, I wonder what's going to happen. And then you got a lot of response. What was your reaction to this?
Well, it was fantastic to see so many people collaborate. As Katja was mentioning, so the task itself seemed kind of simple, but actually what was really interesting when we had the winners come and talk about their different approaches, first of all, actually some of them just collaborated when they're just to present their approach, so that speaks to the point of, you know, their approaches, some of them were not that different.
Right.
And the other aspect also very interesting, I thought, was actually even for us, like trying to learn how people are collaborating. And some of them had some approach, they were trying kind of to trick the pig, so to speak,
yeah.
Right? So it's also learning a lot about how agents, whether humans or AI agents, are also trying to collaborate to achieve a specific task and solve a problem. So that was really interesting. It's beyond the challenge, I think. It's seeing what motivates people, what are the incentives. So it's learning a lot about that too as we design challenges.
So as I'm looking at this, if I was going to form part of this challenge, I would have to program the agent to help me corner the pig effectively.
Exactly.
So I'm a programmer. How do I write this? Because if I remember right, it's written in Java, or at least Minecraft is. Mm-hmm. But can you use any kind of language? How do I get started? What do I do to make this work?
Mm, fantastic question. So we, from the start, designed Project Malmo to be as open as possible. So we didn't want to exclude any audiences. So we put a lot of effort into making this platform actually cross-platform. So it runs on Linux, Windows, macOS. And people can use their favorite programming language to start and code agents. So we are Project Malmo essentially provides an API that hooks into the Minecraft game. So it uses the modding framework to get information about the state of the world and to send commands to Minecraft.
Mm-hmm.
But our platform takes away all the complexity of actually interacting with the Minecraft game so that researchers can just focus on starting to write code of what the agent should observe, how it should interpret those observations, and how it should consequently try to act in the world. The languages we support include C++, Java, Python, Lua, so you know there's a lot for everyone.
I also saw there's a C# one, because that's my favorite one. So when I'm writing stuff, I'm trying to understand what this looks like, because it feels mm-hmm. like there's some kind of wrapper and
yep.
that I'm sending information to, and then I'm querying for information. Is that mm-hmm. the whole of it? What do you say?
Yes, absolutely. I think that.
Yeah, so you really can think about this as this interactive loop
yeah.
between the agent on the one side and the world, the Minecraft environment on the other. So for the person writing the agent, that looks quite simply as you're pulling a state from the environment and then you send an action back. So you can really start to think about this kind of interactive loop that is often used, for example, in reinforcement learning, but that also matches a lot of different interactive scenarios where agents have to generally learn to interact with the world.
One of the things that I noticed is that this challenge was very constrained.
Yeah.
Is there a way that I can code up, let's just say, for example, there's some heuristics about mm-hmm. how I think I could stay alive at night in Minecraft.
Mm-hmm.
And I have kids, so that's why I know a lot about Minecraft, FYI. So let's just say there's certain assumptions I have about staying alive in Minecraft. Is there a way to code it into that so that it could be an unconstrained to see how it actually do something?
Mm-hmm. So the Malmo platform is really open-ended in the sense that it supports infinitely many different tasks. I'm just showing here a small snippet from the XML that
okay.
is actually used to define the collaborative task that we saw earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And you can define kind of the world that the agent enters. You can start from any saved Minecraft game. You can add additional elements. You can draw entities into this world. So you can really set it up in whatever way you like. And then you can provide information about what kinds of agents should be put in that environment. So you can give them a certain reward function, you can give them observations or command handlers. And in this way, there's no limit to what kinds of tasks you can implement there. So if you think you can come up with an agent that will survive the first 20 days, absolutely, that's a task you can try
and
on there.
So they can talk, right?
They can communicate with each other, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
So by communicate with each other, it's like you can send, because I know you can chat on Minecraft, and they can receive that text and do stuff with that.
Exactly, yeah. So you can start to have collaborative tasks where agents have to learn to talk to each other when necessary.
Man, I feel like I just want to start coding something right now. This XML file describes the starting point. Mm-hmm. You mentioned that it has, like, if you could scroll down to where it actually describes the agents, because it looks like our audience can see.
We have the agent here.
So there's an agent. And so that agent, how does it know? That's what it has, what it starts with. Mm-hmm. How do you tell it, like, because I imagine, like, I used to write games a long time ago, and there was this loop that I would be able to know, here's the thing, here's what everything is around it, do this. How do I tell the start file to look at this function, and then what do I get out of that function? You see what I'm asking?
Right. For that, maybe let's look back at the Malmo GitHub repository right here. This comes with a lot of example code, so let's look here. And this is actually a great place to start if you want to figure out what's out there. So you can see there's some C# examples, C++, etc. Many of them are in Python.
Yeah, so it's just super simple to mock up those things.
Dive in there, exactly. We ship with the tutorial, so that is a great starting point to just get a feel for what kind of functionality is supported. And then we can look at maybe the first tutorial, which just demonstrates how to set up a simple agent and kind of set up this interactive loop. So there's a little bit of boilerplate code and just sending the mission XML that you just defined to the Minecraft client. We'll wait until that is all started up, and then once the mission has begun, we can simply access the state of the world by interacting with what's called the agent host. So it's a matter of getting the world state, interpreting the world state in whatever way we want, and then starting to send commands to the environment. Now, this one is not the solved task, so I would say if people want to know more and try it out, check out the tutorial and get started on coding up your first agent.
I mean, this is really impressive because, I mean, like I say, AI, because AI is such a huge topic, and people, when they think AI, they think of machine learning, but, I mean, you can use Dijkstra's algorithm to do stuff in AI.
Yeah.
There's tons of applications for this. What's the future for Project Malmo? What are you most excited about that people may or may not do?
Mm-hmm. Well, I think, first of all, you just mentioned earlier, we did this first challenge that was, you know, we just put it out there, try to figure out what people can come up with. And I think the future, where one of them is already learning from what was put out there, and we're already thinking, and actually it's an invitation to everybody here listening to this live stream, if you have some ideas about what could be another collaborative AI challenge, please just go to GitHub, go on the forum, and bring your ideas, because we're here to learn, and then share with the broader community, like the platform. We will continue to work on the platform, and it will evolve as people start participating.
Awesome.
And,
well, this has been super fun. I am going to go home and try this today. Can I just use this with any version of Minecraft? Do I have to have one that can be modded? How do I download this?
So actually, everything is included in the installer. So if you just go to the GitHub repository, follow the installation instruction, you should be up and running in about half an hour.
Awesome. Thank you, Katja and Evelyn, for a peek into a really creative way to try out AI research. Now I want to go home and play Minecraft. You got me inspired, seriously. I'm really excited. My kids are going to love this. I'm going to teach them how to program with this.